Hello, teachers. I hope that you watched my videos on how to input an experience and manage back and how to add reflections. That's very important so you know what should be in a student's manage back portfolio. Now, the next thing you want to make sure is that you've approved experiences that they are inputting. So how to do that is you would go to Reviews in Progress and you would click on CAS. And right over here it says approvals. These should show you just your CAS students that you need to approve. Under reviews, if you've been asked to be a supervisor and they sent you the review, then that's where you would go. But for right now, we're just going to look at approvals. And when I click on that, hopefully you will see only your students. And right over here, I see Habiba working out at the gym. And let me click on that. This little yellow icon right here is telling you that they've input this information, but it has not been approved by you yet. Right now, it's to be determined. So before I approve it, I want to read what she wrote. She says, I'm going to be going to the gym every day for an hour and a half to work alongside my personal trainer. It's going to require commitment, perseverance, because I haven't been to the gym in a year. I also have to manage my time. My aim is to tone my body and get in shape before the winter break. And I want to lose a couple kilos throughout the journey as well. Now, this is an excellent description because I've asked for where, when, who, what, why. And she's told us she wants to go to the gym for an hour and a half. She's going to be working out with a trainer, and her goal is to lose a couple kilos and to get in shape. And losing a couple kilos is provable. She says that the learning outcomes are strengths and develop areas for growth, that challenges have been undertaken, and she's learned new skills and commitment, perseverance. She's going to be doing this. The date is a problem. She says that this is for 1 week only, from October 23rd to October 28th. So, you know, did she lose a couple kilos in that 5 days, or does she really need to update the date on that? So we might need to leave a note on that. She's written here that her supervisor is Marla, and she's got Marla's email in there. That's great. Might possibly need as well a phone number. So when I scroll down, I'm going to leave a message for her. And I'll say, hi, Habiba, sounds really great. I notice that your dates was for 1 week only. Is that how long your experience lasted? Did you lose a few kilos in that time? Okay, so you can leave a personal message right there, but you could also create preset comments. So I've created these. There's a whole bunch of them, and I might add down here something about make sure that you have your supervisor's email, name, and phone number. Okay, so I could click that off. If I've noticed she hasn't completed her three CAS questions yet, I could click that off. So, you know, I've got this set up so I can just, instead of typing fresh and new all the time, I've just set it up so I can just add these preset comments, and it's really great. And then I'm going to post that note. So that's how I've left her a message. Now, all in all, I think it's a fantastic thing that she's doing. So I'm just going to go right over here to be determined, and I'm going to change it to approved. And now we see that there's a blue thumbs up, and this has been approved, which all looks great. Now, at the very end of this, when she will complete, she will click this button that says complete supervisor review, but we notice that this is not a GIS person. If this were a teacher at GIS, then that's perfect, that she would just push that button, complete supervisor review, and there it goes, it's off, and the teacher just needs to go into the review button and do it. But for anybody who's not on there, under files, CAS, right over here, there's the supervisor form. Then the student would need to take this particular supervisor form, have them fill it out, and then they can take a picture of it, and the student can take a picture of it, and then they can upload it in their, right over here in the reflections and evidence. They can just upload a photo, okay? So I hope that right here, they can upload that supervisor review as a photo, and then it shows under evidence and reflections. So I hope that helps you understand how you can approve and what you're looking for before you approve it.